how I would love to mess about with Bassie. We could do some very messy things together. Wait a second, I am working. Here, look.
Yes, guys, I know. We already talked about Growl, but I felt that that review was far too short, and we didn't really review a lot about this wonderful Reaper. Yes, I know. I have a very bad addiction. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if I was related to this Reaper. You know, Growl's personality and a little bit of my personality are a little bit the same. You know, I can lose focus and I do dawdle a lot. And when I start daydreaming, oh Lord, I just cannot stop myself sometimes. And yeah, I'm a sucker for this Reaper. And let me tell you something. Let me tell you why I love Growl. First of all, a lot of people may know is I love the great white shark. And when I look at Growl's teeth, it reminds me of that shark. I also love his red hair. He's got beautiful long hair that I wish I could have. And those eyes. His eyes are like rubies, like green, beautiful rubies. They're so beautiful to look at. And yeah, I mean, all Reaper eyes are the same, but there's just something about his eyes that are just a slightly different from William's. I don't know what it is. And it's Growl's personality. Between him, his true form and his human form, they're both very nice. And yeah, sometimes Growl's a little ditzy. I mean, we all are ditzy at once in a while. And, you know, Growl doesn't know when to stop and he doesn't know when to give up. And as I said before, I like that. I like it when a character doesn't know when to give up and when it comes to Growl, he doesn't know when to take a clue. But, you know, I think that's what makes him so lovable, and I really cannot wait until season 3. Oh, I can't wait. I can't wait to see my Growl John again. Oh, I can't wait. I just get so excited whenever he was, when he was on, which made watching the first season, guys, for me a real struggle, because whenever there was a scene with Growl, I couldn't breathe. Like, I wanted to scream like a schoolgirl. I don't know why. My heart was going a million miles an hour. I just felt like I wanted to scream off the rooftops. And I knew I couldn't scream because I didn't want the neighbors thinking something was happening and call the cops. So, you know, I had to hold that in. And, oh, my God, it was so difficult. And, you know, all the time I'm just, like, sighing and sighing just because, oh, God. And, you know, Growl himself is a very interesting guy. You know, I don't think he's the tallest. I think Sebastian's actually taller than Growl. And that's an interesting thing, is we don't know if these Reapers do eat anything, or if they just, you know, if they don't need to eat, are they internal, or can they be killed? Can a demon kill a Reaper? And it's very interesting, their job, even though they're soul Reapers, souls can get stolen away from them. And I find that very interesting. And yeah, he's very high energy. He's very high energy. And I think Growl would be a very, you know what? I think Growl would be good on So You Think You Could Dance. Because I think he would blow the competition away. This guy is so flexible. And yeah, I mean, I like the Alice in Wonderland thing. And I bet you guys can't imagine. Guess which scene was my favorite. The one when they go to the kingdom and there's nothing but Growl. I was freaking out. I was like, oh my God, I want that. Let's make that happen. And, you know, even when he fights Sebastian, I always am like, well, that's kind of not fair. You know, you're beating this poor guy. I mean, he didn't do anything. Well, sometimes he deserves it, but not all the time. He doesn't deserve to get beaten up all the time. I mean, he's just so lovable. Look at him. All he wants is some attention. Can you not blame this poor guy? Come on. Though, I'm going to say this, guys, and I'm going to be all serious. I think if Growl did get his hands on Sebastian, I think he would have such a massive nosebleed that he would die. I really do. And I'm also going to say this. Hey, Seal, You made a promise to Grell that if he helped you, he could do whatever he wanted to with Sebastian for an entire day. You didn't keep the promise. Now, come on. Now Grell has every right to be very upset. We all remember that episode. Come on. What's the worst that he could have done? Well, this is Grell we're talking about. So, those shorts, though. Oh, shorts. Good God. Poor baby. Sometimes I'm a little worried about Grell, but other times I'm just not. I mean, oh my God. I love this guy. I love him. I don't know why I'm so addicted to him, but oh my God, I can't get enough. I can't get enough of Grell. And I don't know why. There's just something about him that's just so mysterious and so lovable. You know, he may not be the smartest guy, and he may be, you know, just, you know, he gets distracted a bit, but he's just so lovable. Oh, I just, oh God, Grell. Just love him. I mean, I don't know what I can and cannot say, but let's just say, guys, if there was a full-size doll of Grell, his height, his weight, everything, I would be the first to buy it. I'm just that addicted to him. Oh, and if it talked, too. Like, if somebody made a plushie of Grell that if you squeezed it, it talked, oh, God, I think I would die. I actually think I would go into one and die. I was just saying a couple days ago to my friends, I wish they made a trench coat that from your waist, it would zip up. It would be red like his. It would zip up, and then, you know, in the back, it would have the bow and everything. It would look exactly like his, but, you know, you could zip it up and you could wear it, you know, around like fall and autumn and, you know, things like that. And, oh, God, if they had that, I'd buy it, too. I love Grell. I don't. And, you know, I think he loves Sebastian the same way I love him. He loves Sebastian. He just saw Sebastian for the first time and he's like, oh, my God, I love this guy. I want this guy. And I think, honestly, that's how I fell in love with Grell. I saw Grell's photo before I didn't even know his name or who he was. And I saw it on IMVU on someone's homepage. And I was like, oh my God, I like this guy. I don't know who he is, but I like him. And then when I found out his name and when I heard his voice for the first time, oh my God, I almost went into one. I was like, oh my God, I love this guy. I love him. And it's not often that I can say about a character that I absolutely love. As you guys know, I did make a comment back that, you know, I was a Vegeta girl. I loved Vegeta. Yeah, I even have a hoodie of Vegeta. But I don't have any tattoos of Vegeta. But I do have a tattoo of Grell. That is how much I love this guy. Grell's got my back always. And you know, as I said, it is within the voice of the character. It's not just the character himself. It's the voice. The voice and the personality is what makes this character just so lovable. I mean, yeah, he was a bit ignorant when he was younger. You know, he wasn't all there when he was younger. And when he grew up, those hips, though. I'm sorry, I got distracted. I was thinking about something that I shouldn't be thinking about. Oh, I'm such a pervert sometimes. See, I am like Grell. But, you know, my friends pick on me and they do call me, you know, you are Grell's daughter. I don't know how he had a daughter, but you're his daughter. You know, you get so distracted by the cutest thing that you don't pay attention. And yeah, I mean, I know how Grell feels sometimes, and I really think that Sebastian should stop being such a jerk and give Grell a chance. What's the worst thing this guy's gonna do? Yeah, that's nice. Put that right in his nose. I'm pretty sure he likes that. But then again, Grell is into the whipping, so, you know, Grell might be into the BDSM stuff for all we know. I was going to cut this of not showing Grell getting abused, but come on, guys. That's what partially gives it such great depth. I might cut some of the footage because, you know, I can't talk about everything. But, you know, Growl is definitely one that I think is very important to the story of Black Butler. And I know I've said this before, and I know it's not going to make sense when I say this, guys, but you guys are not going to get the CL review for quite a bit. I'm sorry. It's just not going to happen. I have a solution, but I have to wait till my friends come over to help me, you know, upload the videos and stuff. So it's going to be a while, but I promise you I will do a review on CL. I'm not going to do one on Eloise. I've already said it. I might do one on Pluto if I can get enough footage, you know, because we all love Pluto. Or what does Finny call him? Plu-Plu. I like that name, Plu-Plu. But let's get back to Growl. Look at that I love his camera. I love his camera and his chainsaw. And yeah, I'm going to say this. Sebastian, you're a jerk. You know, Growl was going to help you. You pick him up. He's all excited. And then you just throw him. No, you don't do that. Oh, and by the way, guys, I'm just going to say, if I met Daniel Frederick and he hugged me, because Daniel Frederick's the one who does Growl's American dub voice. If Daniel Frederick hugged me, that's exactly what would happen to me. My brain would fry. I would have the exact expression that Growl had. I would freak out. That's, oh God, do I love this Reaper. And I mean, we've seen Reapers before and we've seen Death Gods, you know, but when it comes to Growl, there is no competition. This man, he's got it all. I mean, dude, a red car too? Is there anything that's not red? Well, that might be red, but I'm not going to say what I was thinking. Oh, but that might be red too. Sorry, I got the giggle. I can't talk serious when Growl's around. I just get into this, like, this schoolgirl mode, and I can't get out of it. I mean, literally Growl's got me wrapped around his finger. There we go with the whipping. But, literally, he's got me wrapped around his finger. I mean, oh my God. I don't think there's nothing I would or would not do for this death god. But anyway, guys, this has gone on long enough. So this is Jahia Moondragon, and I will see you in the next anime. Bye-bye.